Welcome back to You Special. Now I'm here at the Indian Squash Academy with the great Indian squash team themselves, and I'm going to focus on what squash was 10 years ago and what it is today. Ritwik, would you mind answering that question?
Well, 10 years ago, the Indian squash team, the Indian team wasn't that big. Like, there were a few players. Always, actually, in the historic, in the history of Indian squash, there's been like one or two players who played quite seriously, and then the rest have just sort of been playing socially. And I think that there's a big change from that. I think last month when I saw the PSA ranking and the WISPA ranking, there have been 23 players on the circuit who are playing professionally for the country, which is a huge jump from 10 years ago where it was, I think, only me. And then Saurav joined about 5-6 years ago. Yeah, so it was like literally that's how much the change has happened. I think in the next 5 years or so, it's going to be another big jump, and hopefully we'll have 50-60 players playing the circuit, and that's going to make a big, big difference.
Okay, well, we can all agree that squash has definitely evolved over time, and it will continue to do so in the future as well. But first of all, what about our facility right here in Chennai? How has that helped all of you from scratch? Go ahead, Harry.
It's a great facility. I remember just moving here from Chandigarh. It was like a new world to me, like better courts. I mean, 3, 4, 5, any number of coaches here available to help you anytime you want. So I was just happy to be here playing in all glass court and playing in ACs once a week. So I was that was the coolest day of my life. I still remember playing just one day in a week. So it's quite good.
Okay. Well, you all have great coaches, really, especially Major Manyam and Cyrus Poncha. What is the value of such coaches to back you up to climb the ladder, really? Joshna?
Not all of us have the same coaches. Like, a lot of us have gone abroad to train and base ourselves there, and there are people who are from different states who have different coaches. But with Major and Cyrus and them being a part of the federation, they run this place over here, this academy, and they have a very structured program. You know, their kids and players of different levels, so they kind of oversee what program each group has and all of that. So in terms of organization, they're really good, and they're there at every training session, and we have to be there for every session, all the kids from the youngest to the oldest.
So you'd all agree that you have great support from your coach's strength, really. Now, another thing is that how would you personally want to promote the sport of squash? Personally, any steps that you'd like to take as individuals? Because eventually, at the end of the day, y'all are all stars, really, in the eye of the public. Saurav?
I think it's a tough job to just do it individually. But yeah, obviously, you know, individually we need to do really well on the world circuit so we can capture the imagination of the common people, because nothing succeeds like success. On a broader front, I think improving the player base in schools around the country, especially, I think will be a big step forward in raising the profile of the game, because that's where the future lies. And doing that individually, again, is very difficult. So the federation at the national level and at the state level will have to, you know, take initiatives to do that. And I mean, if they ever need us, they know that we're always there to, you know, help them out on that front. But I think that's the single most important thing that needs to be done in terms of getting school kids to play, because their enthusiasm will filter down to their parents as well. And, you know, it's just like a cumulative effect, and squash just raises itself in the eyes of the common man.
Okay, stepping aside from that, on a less serious note, what about personal advertisements, really? Stepping forward that way to showcase yourself on that front, put yourself on a platform so that young squash enthusiasts would probably recognize you and say, I want to take up squash. Deepika.
Well, I think I've done a few, so obviously, I'm used to it. I think put squash on a platform, and I think it's great that, you know, we get opportunities to advertise squash, and hopefully we all can do it.
Okay. Joshna, would you like to answer that question as well?
Honestly, I'm not too, like, I don't go looking or chasing it. If I have to do it because I'm sponsored by a particular company, then I'll do it. But otherwise, I'm quite happy just playing and training.
Okay. Mishra, where do you see yourself right now in the squash team? And say, where do you see yourself 5 years from now as well?
I would be wanting to play the professional Vispa circuit more, and hopefully I can come here and train more so I can get into the team more regularly, which I've been doing for the past few years, but I would want to do it more regularly.
Okay. Well, on that note, we're going to end this segment, second segment of You Special. But on the other side, I've got something very special for you guys, in line for you guys, that's going to catch you off guard. So do stay tuned for this very special segment with the Indian Squash Team.